In this video, we're going to take a look at subqueries inside of a join clause. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, unfortunately, it's really hard for me to show you a good example of why you would do this with the current data set that we have right now. So the example we're going to look at is going to be kind of pointless, kind of contrived, but it's still going to teach you the basics of how to write a subquery that goes into a join clause. Okay, so enough of that. So the rules here are that we can put in any subquery into a join clause right there, or a subquery at it, as long as that subquery returns some data that is compatible with the on clause, so the actual joining expression right there. Let's take a look at an example of this. We're going to first run the subquery by itself to understand the structure of data that comes back. Okay, so over here, I'm going to do a select user ID from orders where product ID is equal to 3. So this is going to tell us all the different user IDs of people who have ordered the product with ID number 3. If we run it, these are going to be the users who ordered that product. Now, in theory, we could use that as a source of data and join it into our users table to find the first name of all the different people who ordered that product. If we think about this in a diagram format, we're essentially saying from the orders table, find us only the orders related to product ID of 3. So that'd be this row right here. That means that we would forget all the other rows, or essentially just dump them. We're then going to use the remaining data right here as the source of data for a join with users. We are joining these two tables together by finding where ID on users is equal to the user ID of orders. In this case, in this diagram, user ID of 5 would match up with that user right there. We can really imagine that we would kind of take this entire row and throw it right there. And then we end up with our join table. We are making use of an inner join here. So for any rows where there is no match, they would all get dumped. So all those other rows get dumped, and we're left with just what you see right here. Now we could select first name, which would give us Michaela out of all this. Now, I just want to point out that the reason that this example is kind of contrived and not super useful is that, well, we could do the exact same thing with a normal join without using any kind of subquery or anything like that. So again, not super useful, but I just want you to understand the mechanics of using a subquery in a join. Okay, so let's go write out the full query now. So back over here, I'm going to select first name from users. We're going to join in some data that is going to come from the result of a subquery. So inside of here, I would select the user ID from orders, and I only want to find the user IDs where this person ordered a product ID of 3. There we go. Now, very much like our subqueries inside of a from clause, we do have to provide an alias for the result of the subquery inside of a join clause. So we are going to provide an alias here of as O, O being short for orders. Then after that, we can put in the on clause, which is going to specify how we're going to join this source of data with users. So in this case, we'll say O.userID. So let's match up the user ID from this source of data with the user's ID, like so. And that should be it. So we can run this, and those are the names of all the people who ordered the product with ID 3. Now, just so you can see that this subquery usage right here is not super useful, we could technically reduce this entire thing, take the subquery out, and just say orders, update that alias right there to orders, and then finally I'll delete the semicolon at the end and put in an aware of orders.productID equals 3. And that would give us the exact same result. So again, not a great example of when to use this, but definitely a good enough example for you to understand the mechanics of using a subquery inside of a join. All right, so I apologize again that I can't give you a better example here. Nonetheless, hopefully we have a good idea of what's going on. Let's move on to the next video where we're going to see the probably most exciting and best usage of subqueries, which is when we make use of them inside of a where expression. So let's take a pause here and tackle that in just a moment.